Hey guys, welcome back to One Piece Pirate Warriors 3. Actually nailed it that time. The City of Water, Water 7. I'm expecting there to be a lot of plot between here and here, so I suggest you stop the video and go for a pee beforehand. Or if you're already on the toilet watching this on your phone, first, you should probably comment and tell me that you're sitting on the toilet, you know, going for a big old poop whilst watching this. I'd very much appreciate it. I would also feel honoured to keep you interested whilst you are pooing. I know that sounds weird, but I'm actually okay with it. We've been Zoro twice, right? And we've been Luffy twice. Let's be Sanji. I like Sanji. Berry growth. Yeah, let's shove. Fucking. You know what? Fucking. There you go. Play two. We're gonna make him uber OP. We're gonna auto use. Look at that. So good. We probably should also put skill slots on, which we've not touched one bit through this, by the way. But better sit yourself down for a lot of plot. エネルを倒し、空島を後にしたムギワラの一味は傷ついたメリー号を修繕すべく船大工を求めて海を進む。その航海の途中、とある島で一味は意外な人物と遭遇した。その人物とは。あららら。
これはいい女になったな、ニコロビン。ロビン、どうした？知ってんのか？こいつのこと。海軍大将、青木氏。大将って、どんだけ偉いやつだよ。俺がここへ来たのは、ニコロビンとモンキー・ディ・ルフィ、お前を一目見るためだったが。 やっぱお前ら今しんどくか。いい仲間に出会ったな。しかしお前はお前だ、ニコロビン。
違う、私はもう。これだけは言っとくぞ。
お前たちはこの先ニコロビンを必ず持て余す。ニコロビンという女の生まれついた星の凶暴性をお前たちは背負いきれなくなる。ここでお前たちの命を絶つのは造作もねえが、クロコダイルの件で借りがある。じゃあな。
Actually, not that much plot.
<笑>海軍大将青木が立ち去り、難を逃れたムギワラの一味は次にログポースが指し示す島、水の都ウォーターセブンに入った。過酷な航海で疲弊しているメリー号の修理を依頼するため、ルフィたちは島の市長アイスバーグが社長を務める造船会社ガレーラカンパニーを訪ねる。しかし、 ルッチらガレーラカンパニーの職長たちの査定の結果、メリー号は致命的な損傷を受けていることが判明。もはや修理は不可能だと告げられてしまう。その間、ロビンは何者かと接触して姿を消してしまう。ロビンの行方がわからず、一味が動揺する中、ウソップは解体やフランキー一家に船の修理に充てるはずの大金を奪われるトラブルに見舞われていた。ウソップを傷つけたフランキー一家に激怒したルフィは、
その後で一つの決断を口にする。ゴーイングメリー号は苦楽を共にした大切な仲間だが、この町で別れようと。船はよ、乗り換えることにしたんだ。ゴーイングメリー号には世話になったけど、この船での航海はここまでだ。待てよ、そんなお前、修理代 足りなくなったのか。違うよ、そうじゃねえ。じゃあなんだよ、なんで乗り換えるなんてくだらねえこと言うんだ。メリー号はもう直せねえんだよ。どうしても直らねえんだ。じゃなきゃこんな話はしねえ。お前、
一流と言われる船大工たちがもうダメだと言っただけで、今までずっと一緒に海を旅してきた大事な仲間を、 ところで見殺しにする気か。
じゃあお前に判断できんのかよ。お前は船大工じゃねえだろ。これは俺が決めたことだ。今更お前が何て言ったって意見は変えねえ。
いいかルフィ、誰でもおめえみてえに前ばっかり向いて生きていけるわけじゃねえ。俺は傷ついた仲間を置き去りにこの先の海へなんて進めねえ。
いい加減にしろお前。お前だけが辛いなんて思うなよ。
だったら乗り換えるなんて答えが出るはずがねえ。
じゃあいいさ、そんなに俺のやり方が気に入らねえんなら今すぐこの船から。うわっ、
バカ野郎だ。ルフィてめえ今何言おうとしたんだ。めったなこと口にするもんじゃねえぞ。
いや、いいんだルフィ、それがお前の本心だろ。
なんだと。
使えねえ仲間は次々に切り捨てて進めばいい。この船に見切りをつけるんなら俺にもそうしろよ。意見が食い違ってまで一緒に旅をすることねえよ。俺はこの一味をやめる。俺と戦え。俺が勝ったらメリーゴーはもらっていく。モンキー D ルフィ、俺と決闘しろ。
Well, that was, I completely forgot all about that. That's fucking such a cool moment in the anime. It was really conveyed really well there. Quick question, have you finished pooing? And if you have not finished pooing, let me know at what point of the video you did finish pooing. And if you did not finish pooing during the course of this video, or if you were not pooing at all, simply put in the comments, did not poop. I really hope people put that in the comments, that'd be amazing. Anyway, moving onwards. Oh, more plot.
お前が俺に勝てるわけねえだろうが。メリーゴはお前の好きにしろよ。新しい船を手に入れてこの先の海へ俺たちは進む。じゃあな、ウソップ。今まで楽しかった。重い。
それがキャプテンだろう。迷うな。お前がフラフラしてやがったら、俺たちは誰を信じりゃいいんだよ。船を明け渡そう。俺たちはもうこの船には戻れねえから。
しんみりしてても始まらねえ。とにかく今はロビンちゃんを探そう。
Alright, well that was fucking pretty heavy. Let's move on. Ooh.Treasure. I have no idea what the fuck we're doing here. I guess we're fighting Frankie, I guess? I don't really know. That's the center of Water 7. Oh, I'm here. Oh shit, pirates. Worker has appeared. Yeah, it's been a show, you workers. Fuck you, workers. Fucking dirty piece of hard working shit. You know what, Sanji might be possibly one of my favorites for their actual combat style. It's like, it's very much, this may be a fucking strange comparison, like the original Zhao Yun, not Zhao Yu, the guy with the spear, Zhao Yun, the guy with now the staff, but he used to have a sword in Dynasty Warriors, and he used to be, like, he was a cone crowd clearer is what we called them, and basically what it was is that he would attack in a cone the people in front of him, right? So it's like he would do damage to those people rather than massive AoEs like crowd clearers or single damages. He would be pretty much like a midway character. He'd kill it pretty much anything in front of him and would do pretty strong damage compared to like Zhao Yu, who's always had a spear, but he's like AoEs, you know? That's pretty much how I saw it. We had like, cause back then, this is gonna make me feel like such a fucking dick. Like, there wasn't really, oh, I'll explain after this.
ロビンちゃん、どこにいたんだよ。探したんだぞ。みんな心配してる。私はもうあなたたちのところへ戻らない。ここで別れよ。この町で。何言い出すんだよ、ロビンちゃん。ああ、そうか。襲撃事件のことだろう。濡れ衣なんて海賊には。昨夜、市長の屋敷に侵入したの。確かに私。え？
あなたたちの知らない闇が闇はいつかあなたたちを滅ぼす。みんなにもよろしく伝えてね。こんな私に今までよくしてくれてありがとう。さよなら。ちょっと待てよ、ロビンちゃん。冗談やめろ。ロビンは俺たちが嫌いになったのかな。
Right, okay, well, what does it say, like, back during, like, you know, Dynasty Warriors 2 and shit, like, the internet was a thing, like, you know, dial-up. And it wasn't like fucking it, like, you know, if your mum answered the phone or something, like, you'd lose connection, you know, you could play RuneScape 1 or something. But like it was so bad, like just nobody used it. No one used it like they use it today, you know? Like you're watching this right now on the internet. You know? Like that's insane. Compared to like when it was. Because it was just kind of strange because you didn't back then you didn't have like any guides or like know-how or any of this like terminology like that. So when you play the game a lot with like your circle of friends, you kind of made up your own terminology for the things. And I guess it's kind of how it works now, but it's kind of like whoever first made up the terminology online, like, gets the rights to it, I guess. Something like that, I don't know. Or someone who comes along and makes a better analogy, like, oh yeah, that makes more sense. So like, then they'll swap to that, I guess. I don't know, can we get a 2 for Sanji? No, I can't get a 2 for Sanji. Not yet, anyway. Maybe we'll get upgraded to that. But yeah, so it's like that kind of happened a lot when you were little, like, you know, like when there was a lot of things, like Pokemon Red was probably one of the biggest ones, because I'll say Pokemon Red. Yeah, Pokemon Red, Blue, Yellow were probably like some of the biggest things because, again, they were there, but before the internet kind of was, then like we would all bring our Game Boys to school. We'd all like show each other all the cool Pokemon we had and all that. And, but at the same time, because of all that, like, you know, like those rumors of Mew that circulated around, I think like every school fucking got this one. It was like, you know, if the one that we got, there was like a bunch of different rumors. I remember like seeing on the internet now, I remember there being like loads of different rumors. But the one that we had. Oh, fuck's sake. More plot.
Hey,
ウォーターセブンの裏の顔。そうだ。俺は人呼んで。フランキー。なんだあの変態。出てこい麦わら。
So the one that was you know, circulating through our school was the one that if you got all 151 Pokemon, you or 150 Pokemon even, including Mewtwo, you would then go to the like Saint Anne area and use surf to get to the truck or something. Like that was like the rumor that was going around, and you know, people fucking did that. They like made little rumors about games, like little creepy things, like the Lavender Town rumor, like that was so creepy and all that shit. And, like, there's so much stuff like before the actual internet, and then like with the internet you have more access to that sort of stuff. But it's in a different kind of way, because now, at least how I feel, like now, some people are a bit more scared to show that side of them. Like a lot of people, like, will give you back chat or like say different things because the internet gives them that sort of like buffer, right? Because like some people in the comments, some people in certain comments and on Twitter, you know, that gives people a certain buffer. That allows them to say things without repercussions. At least that's how they see it. And people can be fucking rude as all hell. I'm not sure how we got onto this topic. People can be all rude as all hell. Like, people have come up on fucking threatening charges and all sorts of shit. Through being so rude through the internet. But it's like, I guarantee you, if those things weren't on the... If he wasn't on the internet, he wouldn't say like that. He wouldn't be talking like that. Because he didn't have that layer of protection. The person that he's talking to could punch him in the face, for example. You know, so it's like, I feel like a lot of people do that because they have a thing of buffer. I personally try to keep it... I try to keep, like, the way I talk, the way I do things online, like in forums or you know, YouTube, the comment sections on Twitter, I try to keep in mind that they're people and that you need to talk to them the same way you would talk to them if you're right in front of them. MMOs especially. Like, you need to talk to them like you would if they were directly in front of your face. And that doesn't... People don't do that today. Let's face it, people don't do that. I try to, my partner tries to, and, you know, I try and make sure people are... doing that, especially in like, you know, our guilds and stuff like that, I do try my best to keep that in mind. But it can be so difficult, right? And at the same time, even like, I say that, but even I am not like fucking flawless. I'm not a fucking trying to say that I'm the best or how I would, that's how I would talk in real life. I mean, I swear a lot in my real life, and I swear a lot here. Generally because it's like, it's got to a point where it's like secondary to anything. I have a foul mouth, I know that. If you have a problem with my foul mouth, I'm very sorry. I don't mean to offend or don't mean anything by it right now, but it's just how my brain reacts. I'm trying to get out of it, because I don't really want to like offend people all the time. But, you know, it's hard when people just don't care half the time. So, I don't know, it's... I really wouldn't like to get, I'd like to get out of that, especially if, you know, I start having kids or anything like that. You don't really want them saying stuff like that, so, you know, how it goes. But it's, but I don't swear a lot because I'm on the internet. I swear a lot because it's just what I do. That was my example. But it's at the same time, at the same time, even I have been known to say things and stuff like that that I would not usually say. Everybody does it, so don't be afraid of anything like that. Everybody does it. Literally everybody. I don't care who you are. You've probably done it at some point, whether by accident or on purpose. Because you don't even think about it, right? That's the thing. Like, you don't think about it, nor do you see it. You just do it. You just do it and you think, that's what I'm saying, that's what I'm talking about. But you don't really think about the added buffer that the internet gives you. Now, I would like you to think about that and see if you actually have done it. And let me know in the comments below if you've done it. And if you can admit to it, I'd be very impressed. But don't feel like you have to. Don't feel like you have to out yourself. Or anything like that. I would just be personally very impressed. Sorry, I'm a little bit burpy there. By the way, has anyone noticed how fucking cool Frankie's design is at now compared to, like, later on? He changes so drastically. I really dislike the new Frankie in comparison to the old one. How do you guys feel about that? Also, let me know about that. There's loads of questions in this video. There's a bunch of questions. I should try and get, like, a question per video, really, because I like having that sort of connection with you guys, and you guys talking to me and giving me, like, little answers to these little dumbass questions that I say during the course of the videos. But yeah, Frankie, you're dead. Go away. Out of fuel. Is that a Coca-Cola? But yeah, internet just gives people that buffer, and it's nothing to be ashamed of, precisely. It's just like, you know, whether you're on the golden rule is, if you're on the internet or not on the internet, wherever you are, just don't be a dick, you know?
世界で唯一古代兵器を復活させれる存在がお前だ。なぜあなたがポーネグリフの存在をそれ兵器のことまで。俺は古代兵器プルトンの設計図を持っている。そんな子供知らずに奴らに協力していると呆れたな。あなた、私の何を知っているの。世界政府の手で私の人生がどれほど狂わされたか。それほど嫌う政府に
Oh, okay, there's a lot of, like, pirate dudes here. More workers, apparently. That's fine. Let's use this. We've not used this yet, which we really should be using it more. But, yeah, so, you know, if you agree with me, let me know. If you disagree with me, also let me know. I don't care which way you look. It's all to your own personal view at the same time. But I feel, you know, golden rule, whether you're on the internet or not on the internet, just try not to be a dick. Try not to be a dick. It's impossible. I'm a dick all the time. Like right now, I'm being a dick. I don't even know it. So, you know, it can happen. I'm being a dick by telling you not to be a dick, even though I don't know if you're a dick or not. Which you're probably not. You're probably a lovely person. In fact, I know most of you are lovely people. Because you put lovely comments on my videos, and they're lovely. So, I know you're lovely people. But yeah, I'm still telling you not to be a dick. Well, I'm not telling you directly, I'm telling everybody. I'm telling the whole universe. Don't be a penis. If you can avoid being a penis, do so. I know I'm being a penis, but that's okay. I have special rights. I'm on YouTube, that means I can do what I like, right? that's how it works, yeah? I can say crazy things. And people will listen to me. That's what it means, right? I hope that's what it means. Otherwise I got into this for the wrong reason. Damn. Okay, is it I? Oh, wait, hang on, what? The question mark's back there? Why is the question mark back there? Let's go back to the question mark. I'm all confused. Okay, let's keep going. I guess we just gotta take this over. Oh, just us sneaking in. This might be us sneaking in. I don't know. I love this part. I love this part of the anime. This fucking DS what I didn't do. It just came out of my brain. It's come out of my mouth hole. So you know. I love this part of the anime. It's so good. It's ridiculous. How good like the Water 7 slash I don't even know what the next bit's called. What the area is. Fucking, you know, the world government section is just so awesome. The hell is grown back. What is this? Just what is this sorcery? This trickery. Get off, Luffy. Is this ours now? Territory captured again? Alright, a gate guard is guarding it. What the fuck is this? A worker is here. How the hell do we do this? Do we just need to keep breaking in? Let's break into it one more time. If this doesn't work. Oh, Nami was unlocking the gates. I see. I see. I get it now. Isn't I already helped her out? Yeah, I already helped him. But he's fine. He's sitting there. He's happy. He's happy as Larry. Good old Larry. Okay, did we do it? The gate guard is. Yeah, so he's just gonna fucking regen. Right, whatever. We're gonna go help Nami get in here. That's what we're gonna do. Nami, I'm coming. Close Chopper. Sexy Sanji and Cute Chopper are on the way to help you, Nami. Hello, Nami. We are here. Pretty Nami. Yeah, I did come to help you. Yay! See, she's so happy that we came to help. That's good. Are we going up here? Okay. Zoro and Luffy are probably fine over there. They're probably okay. I don't see why they wouldn't be. Let's do this kick again. So Sanji's next move is like a flame kick, right? Like, gets loads of fire and shit around his foot. Like, does a weird devil kick or something. Which is weird, because, like, without even having the flare fruit, Sanji and Luffy both can put, like, flames around themselves. Probably just a, visual effect. Like, not. Whether it's, like, actually there or something, I don't know. Take it at face value, I guess. I'm not even gonna ask for an explanation of how that works. Oh, look at the little dinghy down there. That. Okay, Nami, what you doing? Are you gonna help us here or not? What's the dealio? Nami-san? Nami. Oop, almost ran into a pool of water. And Chopper? Chopper and Nama? Hey, what are you gonna do? No, you're not gonna open that one? Are we going straight for the house? Maybe we're going straight for the house. That's fine, I can break your way. I can kick my way in there. You just keep running. You'll get there soon enough. And I'll clear the way. How's that a worker? He's got boxing gloves on his shit. Ooh, fucking ballerina music. Pretty badass, Sanji. Wah. Like a triple axel or something, whatever they're called. Maybe a triple axel. Also, let me know that. Hope you're writing these down. Hope you're writing your comment as you are watching the video, and then you post all of it at once. So it's like I pooed at 4:07 minutes into video. Thank you for keeping me entertained whilst pooping. Yes, I have been a dick online maybe once or twice. No, I have not been a dick. I am a lovely person. Maybe that's also an option. Other stuff. Wait, what was your favorite? Did you prefer Frankie in this way or not in this way? Who knows? Good job, Nami. Hey, Robin.
この犠牲が出る前にお話しください。アイスバーグさん。お前ら、政府の人間だったのか。そう。我々はサイファーポールナンバー9。潜伏など造作もない任務。しかし、この件に費やす時間も制限時間を迎えました。 話を続けましょう。設計図のありかについて、実は我々には一つの仮説があります。思慮深いあなたは、自分が殺される可能性を考えて、設計図が所有者を失わないよう誰かに託した可能性が高い。ここで興味深い事実がある。かつてこの島にはトムという名の伝説の船大工がいて、 弟子を2人取っていた。兄弟子はあなたで、弟弟子はカティ・フラムという男だ。しかしその男はすでに事故で死んでいるはずだった。だが弟弟子は生きていた。フランキーと名を変えて設計図を託した相手が唯一の弟弟子なら我々も納得できる。
あくまで仮説だったが、あなたのその反応がそれを的中だと告げた。ロビン、やっと見つけたぞ。私は先に行ってる。おい、待て。行くなよ、ロビン。吠えやしない。諦めろ。
Shit, okay, well we found Robin, but she's gonna disappear soon. Ready? Ready, watch this go. She's just gonna go poof. Oh. Shit, okay. This guy. This is gonna be an intense fight. It's gonna be an epic fight of epic proportions. We're gonna get Luffy on in here. With Buffalo Bill here. See how like super into it he already is? He has abilities that we've not even learned yet, but we will at some point, I'm sure. Well, even Luffy will. I don't know if some of the others will. What do I do? I think Sanji learns to like kick the air, right? Or something. Some sort of thing. Okay, it's just me and you now, buddy. Yeah. My kicks against yours, and my kicks win. Good job, Sanji. Good job, everybody. Hope you enjoyed your poop. That was a good poop. I liked it. That was a good one. Good job, guys. Do not tweet it at me. I will. No, that, I'm not even gonna. I was gonna offer something very strange then. that's not even a thing. I don't really want that as growth. Jesus, that made me vomit.
CP9は物心ついた時より政府のために命を使う覚悟と人体の限界を超えるための訓練を受けてきた。そして得た力が6式。あまり調子に乗らんことだ。 世界政府の重要任務を任される我々と、たかだか一海賊団のお前たちとの桁違いの戦闘力の差はこんなものではない。せっかくだ、最後に面白いものを見せようか。猫猫の実モデルレオパルド。表人間か。違う。
外まで止め